Dear students, welcome to the online classes of Animal Biotechnology. Today I will discuss about the genetic engineering of mammalian cells. So in this topic, I will discuss about IVF, in vitro fertilization, and embryo transfer technology in humans. I will discuss about IVF and embryo culture in farm animals like cow. And finally, I will discuss about some transgenic animals. So first, IVF or in vitro fertilization. In vitro is performed or taking place in a test tube, culture dish or elsewhere outside the living organism. And this word in vitro was originated from the Latin word that is vitro. Its literal meaning is glass. So in IVF, fertilization takes place outside of human body, particularly in culture dish. And the babies produced using this IVF technique are called test tube babies. So why there is a need of IVF? Actually, infertility is a common and serious problem of reproduction on these days. So embryo cell culture methods provide a solution to this infertility problem through the technique of IVF and embryo transfer. Now, history of IVF. Actually, Sir Robert Edward, a UK scientist, developed these techniques first, and he got a Nobel Prize in 2010 for physiology and medicine. And here you can see the picture of the first baby who was born using this IVF technique. Her name is Louise Brown. Now she is 41 year old and she is quite healthy. And in India, Kanupriya Agrawal or Durga is the first test tube baby of India. Now there are some facts about IVF in India. So actually Dr. Subhas Mukhopadhyay was a physician in the Bihar state, and she created the first IVF and world's second IVF child and named her Durga. And Durga was born only 67 days after the first IVF baby in United Kingdom. But unfortunately, he was harassed by the then Bihar government and not allowed to share his achievement with the international scientific community. So what he was dejected and frustrated by this act of government, and he committed suicide in 1981. This is shocking fact. And there was a movie Ek Doctor Ki Maut was released in 1990, and it was based on the story of Dr. Mukhopadhyay. So these are the some infamous history of IVF in India. Now come into the science. So what is IVF? And here you can see the various steps of in vitro fertilization. So the first step of IVF is the egg production. So eggs are overproduced in the woman, and the success of IVF largely depends on the growing a multiple eggs at once. So growing of multiple eggs at once are also called super ovulation. So this super ovulation is induced by some natural hormones like FSH and LH, and these are called gonadotropin hormones. And these gonadotropin hormones can be injected to women from day 2 to day 10 of her menstrual cycle, and after 10 days multiple eggs are produced inside the ovary of that woman. So in the second step, these eggs are removed from the ovary with a needle under the ultrasound guidance, and anesthesia is provided to make this comfortable. In the third step, sperm samples are collected, and in the fourth step, egg and the sperm are combined and incubated to allow fertilization, or the fusion of sperm and ova can take place by the micromanipulation. So what is micro manipulation? It is intracytoplasmic sperm injection, that is ICSI. So in this case, pipette or very thin needle is used to pierce the oocyte cell membrane and sperm is injected directly inside the cytoplasm of the egg. So fertilization takes place in this manner also. And finally, in fifth step, the fertilized egg are cultured in the lab condition for 3 to 5 days and embryos are developed. And the healthy embryos are implanted into the uterus by the embryo transfer technology, and some healthy embryos are also preserved in very low temperature, that is called cryopreservation. So the embryo transfer technology is quite critical for humans. So what is embryo transfer technology? Actually, after a few days of development, the best appearing embryo are selected for the transfer. Actually, embryo generally in 2 to 4 cell stage are placed in uterine cavity with a thin tube. And excess embryo of sufficient quality that are not transferred can be frozen, as I already discussed, they can be cryopreserved. So there are the steps involved in the embryo transfer in human. First, the patient is placed in lithotomy position, that is called knee and chest position. Then a sterile bivalve speculum is inserted to visualize the cervix. So here you can see the speculum. The cervical canal and uterine cavity are aligned. Then the embryo or embryos are drawn into a Teflon catheter. Here you can see the Teflon catheter in the which are in the tissue culture media. All embryos are in tissue culture media and they are taken by the this Teflon catheter. And Teflon is used because it is very less adhesive. And then the catheter is inserted into the uterine cavity. Here you can see this catheter is inserted into the uterine cavity. And then embryo are gently inserted in culture media and the catheter and cannula are gently withdrawn. So here you can see how the embryos are expelled from the catheter in the uterine cavity. And this catheter is examined under the microscope or ultrasonography to ensure that the embryo have been expelled properly. And finally, embryo further allowed to grow inside the uterus as a normal pregnancy. Now, it is also possible to make some embryo transfer technique in animal. Actually, this technique was developed before the embryo transfer technology in human. So the first calf produced experimentally through embryo transfer technology was born in 1951 in USA, but it was become famous in 1970s. So there are two procedures presently available for the production of embryo from donor female in calf or other cattle. First is superovulation followed by artificial insemination and then flushing the uterus to gather the embryo, and embryo are splitted in the various fragments. And second step or second procedure is in vitro fertilization, which is exactly like the in vitro fertilization technique of human. So here in this figure, the first procedure is mentioned. In this case, you can see the sperm are taken from the healthy bull, and cow is artificially inseminated with these sperms, and then zygote develop into embryo inside the cow, and then this embryo or these embryos are removed from the cow and they are splitted into various fragments in the cell culture media. And here you can see embryos are split into several smaller embryo, and each of which can grow into the new calf. And these embryo are then placed inside uterus of the foster mothers. And finally, you can get the progeny, and which contain the some healthy traits, or you can improve the breed of that cow. Here you can see two identical twins are bond with the result of embryo splitting techniques. Now, transgenic animal, or the step involved in the transgenic animal. So last week I have explained how transgenic mouse was created. So here the methodology or the steps are mentioned. So first, you have to identify the gene which you want to transfect inside the host. So this gene is called target gene. So target gene may be any gene. It may be disease resistance gene. It may be any enzyme like lactase. If you want to produce lactose free milk from the cow, so you can introduce lactase gene. So that is the identification of gene. So that gene target. Second is isolation of gene target. You can isolate DNA from the organism that contain the target gene, and after isolation of DNA, you can amplify that particular DNA or target DNA by the PCR technique, and that amplified DNA then cloned in the desired vector. And finally, third step is transformation, transfection, and that desired vector is inserted or transfected into the embryo, particularly into cell or three cell stage. Here in this figure, you can see how transgenic animals or how transgenic mammals have been created. First, you can see the, suppose this is a gene for milk protein. It is ligated with a foreign gene. So here you have a transgenic gene, or you have the hybrid gene, which is coding for regulatory milk gene as well as coding for a foreign gene. This construct you can inject or micro inject inside the embryo, particularly in single cell stage, and then this embryo can be transferred to the respective mammal. Here you can see the various mammals which are produced by this transgenic technique, and these transgenic you can see the progeny of transgenic animals, their milk containing the protein of foreign origin. And so far there have been many transgenic livestock developed. So they can act as a bioreactor actually, because they can continuously produce some specific protein in their milk or in their wool. So they are more economical than producing desired protein in cell culture or lab condition. So here you can see the transgenic cow or mate to produce proteins lactoferrin and interferons in their milk, and it is also possible to create prion free cows, and these cows are resistant to mad cow disease. Creation of sheep, transgenic sheep, is also possible, and actually we created them for the good quality of wool production. And transgenic goats have been created that could express tissue plasminogen activator enzyme, anti-thrombin 3 enzyme, and spider silk in their milk. Now, the transgenic feces and how transgenic feces are created. So here in this figure, you can see the sperm and ova are fused, and they form means this, they are called fertilized egg in this case. And you can inject or micro inject a gene construct in these fertilized eggs. Suppose here you can make a gene construct. You can suppose this is the gene for growth hormone. So once this gene is cloned in desired vector, and this desired vector is called construct, and this construct is micro injected inside the fertilized egg, and this construct is integrated with the these X genome, and you can allow to develop X into the small feces or fries, and you can see the difference between the growth pattern of these fries. And you can select the fry which are growing rapidly because you have introduced growth hormone in this, and then you can further breed to stabilize the transgene, and finally you will have the transgenic fishes which can grow very rapidly into F2 generation. So what are the application of transgenic fishes? So you can see here there are many applications of transgenic fishes. So development process of eukaryotes, you can see the regulation of various biological process like disease versus healthy condition. You can also study some developmental biology and endocrinological studies in these fishes. Economic benefits, like I have mentioned, if you introduce growth hormone, the fish will gain weight very rapidly. And so there are nutritional benefits as well. Efficient utilization of nutrients such as plant fiber and phytate you can utilize in these transgenic fishes. There are some environmental impact also. So minimal environmental pollution due to the minimal release of nutrient into water. And there is production of some pharmaceutical products such as fatty acid and pharmaceuticals for human application. You can also produce some pharmaceutical products in these transgenic fishes. Transgenic fishes serve as a model for human disease. So these transgenic fishes can work as an experimental model. And developing novel strain with resistance to infectious agents or infectious disease. So you can also develop some transgenic fishes which are resistant to infectious disease. So that's all about the modern techniques like IVF, embryo transfer technology and transgenic animals. Next week I will start a new topic. Till then, bye bye, take care. Thank you very much.